गुड मॉर्निंग, गुड आफ्टरनून एंड गुड इवनिंग प्यारे बच्चों। इन दिस लेक्चर वी विल बी कंसंट्रेटिंग इन लॉरेंज फोर्सेस विच बेसिकली डील्स विद द फोर्स एक्सपीरियंस्ड बाय अ चार्ज पार्टिकल व्हेन इट इज मूविंग इन द कंबाइंड एक्शन ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक एंड मैग्नेटिक फील्ड। Let's go ahead with Lorentz forces. As already we have discussed that when a charge particle is there existing in charge Q existing in electric field E feels a force QE, and when a charge particle Q moving with velocity V in magnetic field B, making some angle, okay, the force experienced is this much. These forces added vectorially give a rise to Lorentz force. This force F is Lorentz force. It's okay. As studied, this will be, charge particle will be experiencing the force due to electric field, as already explained. Positive charge, will experience a force along the field. Negative charge in the field will experience a force opposite to the electric field. And in the same way, charge particle when is in magnetic field, so as it is told, in the same way the force will be experienced. Basically, if we talk of this total force is Lorentz force, and this basically is vector sum of force due to electric field plus force due to magnetic field. It's okay. Now let's take an example. This F is Lorentz force. Let's take a situation to understand this particular thing better. Velocity of the charge particle, magnetic field induction and electric field all are parallel to each other. Okay, and the charge particle is positive. Okay, this is magnetic field. And along the same axis, we have parallel electric field. A charge particle, positive, is fired in the field with velocity V. Parallel to, charge particle is positive. What will be the total force acting on the charge particle and will be in which direction? Now, Force due to electric field will be equal to charge. Charge is Q plus Q. Okay, so force will be Q into E. As the charge particle is positive, so the force, direction of force will be along E vector. It's okay. We have got the information about the force due to electric field. Now, force due to magnetic field. Magnetic field. Charge is Q. Okay. Velocity vector and magnetic field induction vector both are parallel. So theta will be equal to 0. V sine of 0 degree. Okay. Therefore, this force is equal to 0. Mean, no force is acting on the charge particle, okay, when it is moving parallel to magnetic field. Therefore, Lorentz force in the situation will be equal to F is equal to force electric field plus force magnetic field vector sum will be equal to Q into E. What will be direction? The total force. Q into E along. Whatever will be the direction of electric force, that same will be the direction of the Lorentz force along E. Why? Because no magnetic force is acting on the charge particle. Basically, if you talk of Lorentz force, we are talking of the reality. As earlier I have told you, we don't have, you know, electric field only. Okay, in some specific region, we have only electric field. If I am saying this thing, okay, we have only electric field, that is not the reality. If I am saying, okay, we have magnetic field only in our region, that again is not a reality. As I told you, okay, wherever we have electric field, in the same region we have magnetic field present. Okay, because you know, wearing magnetic field produces wearing electric field. Wearing electric field produces magnetic field. Basically, the thing which we have, that is electromagnetic field, mean combined electric and magnetic field. Okay, so this is the reality. Electric field is not the reality. Magnetic field is not the reality. Electromagnetic field is the reality. Okay, so Lorentz force basically is defining the electromagnetic force on a charged particle. Okay, let's take another situation. This is the situation. Magnetic field is this way. Electric field is perpendicular to it this way. And velocity perpendicularly out from the page. Perpendicularly out from the page. Now, total force acting on the charged particle. Okay? Mean charged particle perpendicularly out from the page is tarah se aa raha hai. Aise. Fine. Now, force due to electric field will be equal to force electric field. Charge particle is positive, Q into E. Charge particle is positive, so along E. It's okay. Force due to magnetic field on the charge particle. Ab velocity kidhar hai? Velocity is perpendicularly out. Okay, perpendicularly out. Now, when you will be using, chalo pehle to force likhte hain, chalo. F, force due to magnetic field, Q, V, B, V or B, both are perpendicular, kyunki V is perpendicularly out, sine of 90, charge particle is positive, to force due to magnetic field is Q, V, B. What will be the direction of this force? V cross B. V cross B. Yes? V is perpendicularly out and B is this way. Aram se pause karke, think of the direction. The charged particle is positive. Velocity is perpendicularly out from the page. Perpendicularly out. And B is this way. Magnetic field. Now, applying right hand thumb rule. Right hand thumb rule kis tarah se apply hoga? We have to curl the fingers from V to B. This is V. V. This is B. V to B. Finger line will be, you know, perpendicularly out from the page. Perpendicular to the page. Okay? Humne yahan se B tak usko curl kiya. Thumb kidhar point kar raha hai? Thumb is pointing against electric field. See, because the charge particle is positive, the direction will be as given by the right hand thumb rule. Agar ye charge particle negative hota, to jo bhi direction right hand thumb rule de raha hai, to uska opposite direction hum lete. Okay, to magnetic field induction is this way, velocity is this way. V cross B will be providing the direction of force which is acting on the charge particle due to magnetic field, and that direction which I am getting in the situation is against the electric field. This force due to magnetic field is against E vector. E vector is this way, the force acting is this way. Mean Two forces are acting on the charge particle. One is along the electric field, that is force due to electric field, and another force which is acting is against that electric field, that is force due to magnetic field. Both the forces are opposing each other. Both the forces are opposing each other. Okay, the net force acting on this particular charge will be, first thing, either it will be along this or this. It will be depending on which of the force is greater, Fe or Fb. Okay, if Fe will be greater, if electric force due to electric field will be greater than force due to magnetic field, then jo net force jo hoga, that will be difference of both the forces. First thing, okay, net force is equal to QE minus QVB. This will be the net force, Lorentz force hoga ye. Aur iska direction kya hoga? Because force due to electric field is greater, to iska force along E hoga. Along E. It's okay. And other situation is if आपने इसका वेलोसिटी बढ़ा दिया, ठीक है, चार्ज पार्टिकल का, इफ फोर्स मैग्नेटिक ग्रेटर हो गया, बिकॉज वेलोसिटी इंक्रीज करेगा, देन फोर्स ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ऑन द चार्ज पार्टिकल विल इंक्रीज. तो फोर्स ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड ग्रेटर देन फोर्स ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड. तो इन दैट वेरी सिचुएशन नेट फोर्स विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू वी बी माइनस क्यू ई. And the direction will be against E. Against E. You know, there is a specific case. अब देखो, अगर ये force electric field वाला predominate करता है, तो ये हमने जो charge particle fire किया था perpendicularly out from the page, यहां से निकला था, तो ये धीरे 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 इस direction में ऐसे घूमेगा. अगर magnetic वाला force okay predominate करता है, तो slowly steadily it will be going in the direction of magnet, okay, force due to magnetic field. लेकिन a situation, a particular situation will arise, okay, when we are firing the charge particle with particular value of velocity, okay, with particular velocity, with unique value of velocity, when the force due to magnetic field and force due to electric field both will be equal. Now the charge which is moving in the given situation, when E is this way, B is this way, and V is perpendicular, charge is having that unique value of velocity, okay, that unique value of velocity, that force. Ab dekho, force electric field ke karan jo hai, that is not a velocity dependent force. Force due to electric field will be remaining same, okay, along E. Force due to मैग्नेटिक फील्ड विल बी क्यू वी बी. हमने वेलोसिटी बढ़ा दिया है, ओके, एंड कॉरेस्पॉन्डिंग टू सम यूनिक वैल्यू ऑफ वेलोसिटी, देखो व्हाट विल बी हैपनिंग. ओके, वेलोसिटी इज इंक्रीज टू दैट पर्टिकुलर एक्सटेंट, ओके, कि फोर्स ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड इज इक्वल टू फोर्स ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड, बट बोथ आर against each other. Okay, in the given situation we are having electric force and magnetic force in opposite directions with respect to each other, but yahan pe maine velocity is tarike se increase kiya hai. The way I have increased velocity is ke electric force and magnetic force, they have become equal in magnitude. Opposite to already thi. Okay, so in that situation, net force acting on charge particle will be equal to zero. And when the net force acting on charge particle will be equal to zero, it will be moving undeflected. Undeflected mean, uska kya matlab hai? It will not be deflected from its path. Ye perpendicularly out bahar aa raha tha, so it will be moving on a straight path, undeflected. So when these two forces will be equal and opposite, net force acting on the charge particle will be equal to zero, and net force acting on the charge particle equal to zero mean the particle will not be deflected at all. On whatever path it was entering the combined field, on the same path, along the same path, okay, it will keep moving and will pass through the combined action of the fields. If I, you know, ask you, what is the value of velocity? Find the value of velocity with which the particle must be projected so that in this particular situation, when E, B and V, they both are perpendicular like this. B is this way, E is this way, and V is this way. Okay, in this situation, if I ask you about with what velocity the particle should be fired so as to pass through the combined action of the fields undeflected, then kya hoga? Kab hoga ye situation? Force electric is equal to force magnetic. Opposite to ye dono hai hi. Force electric will be electric field ke karan QE and force magnetic field ke karan QVB. This will be the value of velocity corresponding to which this will be happening. And what should be its value? See, its value should be E by B. Electric field intensity divided by strength of magnetic field. Magnetic field induction. Ratio of these two strengths give us the value of velocity. And this is the particular situation when the charged particle passes through the field undeflected. It's okay. Now let's take another situation. Now in this given situation, we have magnetic field this way, electric field this way. Okay, charge particle which is moving in the field is negative. Q is equal to negative. And velocity of the charge particle again is same, perpendicularly out of the field. Perpendicularly out from page, with respect to page. Mean that is coming out like this. Theek hai? Ab, which all forces will be acting due to individual fields. Theek hai? तो वही बात, टोटल लोड एंड फोर्स फाइंड कर देते हैं. ये लो, नेगेटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल, नेगेटिव चार्ज पार्टिकल, तो फोर्स किधर एक्ट करेगा? फोर्स एक्टिंग सबसे पहली बात कितना, हाउ मच फोर्स विल बी एक्टिंग. फोर्स एक्टिंग विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू इनटू ई. इट्स ओके. किस डायरेक्शन में होगा? अगेंस्ट ई, इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड के अगेंस्ट, अगेंस्ट ई. इट्स क्लियर? ठीक है, ये है फोर्स इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड के कारण. नाउ फोर्स मैग्नेटिक फील्ड के कारण एफ बी, क्यू वी पी साइन ऑफ 90, थीटा 90 ना, वी इज परपेंडिकुलरली आउट फ्रॉम द पेज एंड दिस इज बी. तो फोर्स ड्यू टू मैग्नेटिक फील्ड इज इक्वल टू क्यू वी बी. इन विच डायरेक्शन, ध्यान से देखने की जरूरत है. देखो, नाउ व्हाट इज डायरेक्शन ऑफ वेलोसिटी? वी इज परपेंडिकुलरली आउट फ्रॉम पेज, परपेंडिकुलरली आउट फ्रॉम पेज. बी इज दिस वे, तो आई विल बी अप्लाइंग राइट हैंड थंब रूल. वी लाइक दिस, परपेंडिकुलरली आउट फ्रॉम द पेज. बी इज दिस वे, तो आई विल बी कर्लिंग माई फिंगर्स लाइक दिस. फ्रॉम वी टू बी, द डायरेक्शन ऑफ थंब, डायरेक्शन ऑफ थंब इज जस्ट सी, for a positive charge particle. But in the situation I have a negative charge particle, so whatever direction this right hand thumb rule will give, okay, so direction of force jo hoga negative charge particle, agar to positive hota to thumb ke direction mein, ab ye charge particle negative hai to opposite to that, matlab it will be along E, it will be along E. So force due to magnetic field QVB against E, direction E ke respect mein le lete hain. This is against, nahi, along E hoga, along E hoga beta. Negative charge particle na, so it will be along E. Clear? Theek hai. Ab नेट फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द चार्ज पार्टिकल। ये देखो इस डायरेक्शन में आपका अगेंस्ट ई इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स है और अलोंग ई दिस इज मैग्नेटिक फोर्स। ठीक है, तो दोनों का जो भी डिफरेंस आएगा एंड वट एवर फोर्स विल बी बिगर उसी डायरेक्शन में नेट फोर्स लगेगा और जो देखो पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन लेके कर लेते हैं। नाउ थ्री केसेस बनेंगे व्हेन फोर्स इलेक्ट्रिक इज ग्रेटर देन फोर्स मैग्नेटिक। तो क्या होगा, नेट फोर्स विल बी डिफरेंस ऑफ बोथ द फोर्सेस दैट इज क्यू ई माइनस क्यू वी बी। इसका डायरेक्शन क्या होगा, डायरेक्शन क्या होगा, ओके नेट फोर्स विल बी अलोंग द फोर्स विच इज फोर्स ड्यू टू इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड दैट इज अगेंस्ट इलेक्ट्रिक। तो ये चार्ज पार्टिकल सीधा हमारा आ रहा था तो धीरे 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 इधर घूम जाएगा। ठीक है बेटा, तो इट विल बी नेट फोर्स अलोंग फोर्स ई ऑपोजिट अगेंस्ट ई वेक्टर। इट्स ओके। सेकेंड सिचुएशन में भी व्हेन फोर्स मैग्नेटिक इज प्रेडोमिनेटिंग, वेलोसिटी इंक्रीज कर दिया तो मैग्नेटिक फोर्स ने प्रेडोमिनेट करना स्टार्ट किया। इन दैट वेरी सिचुएशन नेट फोर्स विल बी इक्वल टू क्यू वी बी माइनस क्यू ई। कहां होगा, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वाले फोर्स के डायरेक्शन में, मैग्नेटिक फील्ड वाला जो फोर्स है दैट इज अलोंग ई। सो इट विल बी अलोंग ई। और वही थर्ड सिचुएशन जो यहां पे अराइज हो सकता है, ओके बोथ द फोर्सेस द वेलोसिटी मे बी समथिंग लाइक दैट कि फोर्स मैग्नेटिक इज इक्वल टू फोर्स इलेक्ट्रिक। इन दैट वेरी सिचुएशन क्यू वी बी इज इक्वल टू क्यू ई एंड नेट फोर्स एक्टिंग ऑन द चार्ज पार्टिकल विल बी जीरो एंड द पार्टिकल विल मूव अनडिफ्लेक्टेड। इट्स ओके। व्हाट विल बी द वैल्यू ऑफ वेलोसिटी, क्यू एंड क्यू गॉन, वी इज इक्वल टू ई बाय बी। इट्स क्लियर, जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग। ओके, सो मेनी अदर केसेस फॉर द बेटर अंडरस्टैंडिंग यू कैन एज्यूम एंड यू कैन सॉल्व। होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग। ओके, सो गो थ्रू दिस इन अ गुड वे। ओके, और बुक से भी इसको गो थ्रू करना है एंड इफ यू स्टिल हैव एनी काइंड ऑफ कंफ्यूजन लेट मी नो अबाउट। फाइन, थैंक यू, हैव अ नाइस डे।